Hello, everyone who have sidereal ascendant Aquarius or moon in Aquarius. If you are following the modern tropical astrology, this will be Pisces. So sidereal Aquarius, modern astrology, Pisces, ascendant. We'll be describing the ascendants to see how the planetary configurations of the year 2022 will influence you. So this will be about ascendant Aquarius, sidereal, tropical Pisces. So let's see what is happening. First of all, there is one very good celestial event, very helpful and blessing for you. And this is that almost 1 year from end November 2021 to November 2022, Jupiter will be on your ascendant. This is really very, very nice. Jupiter on the ascendant is a true blessing. He was quite weak in Capricorn, even though he participated in the Great Conjunction on the 21st of December 2020. So, yes, he participated in the Great Conjunction, and with this, he gave you probably this awakening, seeing the reality with different eyes, spiritual events, maybe because all this happened on your 12th house. And because Saturn is your ascendant ruler, and both Jupiter and Saturn met in sidereal Capricorn. Now, Saturn rules the old ruler of Aquarius, he rules your ascendant. And also in the year 2020, he remains in Capricorn, which means that the emphasis of the year, the main topic of the year, will not change also in the year 2022, because it is a process of change which has started end of January 2020 and continues. It's not over. So Saturn is in Capricorn, and what he started changing, he will keep changing until he leaves Capricorn. So this is your 12th house. In the 12th house, it is considered the house of the bad karma, but I don't think that he's giving you such bad karma, but he gives you lessons in terms of enemies, like people can turn into enemies, and then you see who are your true friends, how you find ways to deal with them. Indeed, this will have to do with health, but not health in a way like you may be more interested in the topic of health. You may have some health disharmonies, most probably chronic, that you need to deal with, that you need to solve. Also, he may give you desire to be more in solitude, like spend time on your own in a temple or in your own place. Like this transit will not make you very social. It will be more about you, yourself, your own development, your own awakening. In addition, this may have to do with money and changes in your in money in general, how you spend, how you invest, how you make money, because of the result of the Great Conjunction Jupiter-Saturn. And both, and Jupiter rules your 11th and 2nd houses, all related to, both related to finances. So these are areas of your life which are being touched upon. The years, the difference of this year, the difference between year 2021 and 2022 is that, yes, the topic of change remains, but now you will feel better because Jupiter is now on your ascendant. And also because on the first appearance of the moon for the month of Nisanu showed very interesting chart, which is having Jupiter and Venus on your ascendant, which means that the year will be in a way under their blessing for you. So whatever you do, you will have the protection, you will have the blessing, you will be somehow protected, and the process of change will be much better now, smoother in the coming year than the year before. Now watch out a little bit with your health. stay away from disputes, conflicts. You may see indeed people that turn into, some they turn into enemies, but deal with this also very diplomatically, because on the same day of the 1st of Nisan, Mars and Saturn made exact conjunction on your 12th house, which means in particularly to be careful with hidden enemies, and also with to make sure that you maintain healthy lifestyle. I don't think that you were so much influenced in the year 2022 from the coming eclipses. They happen on the axis of Libra Aries, but if this is so, if the ninth, third house axis happens to be your midheaven, lower meridian, could be that you experience a little bit more and these energies. Around the timings of the eclipses, you may have, let's say, spiritual experiences, temporary lack of study, lack of luck around study processes, study timings, around traveling, a bit like that. This is why, to be on the safe side, watch out a bit and don't do important moves, important initiatives around. The first solar eclipse is happening on the 30th of April, meaning from 25th of April until end of May, because I'm including the second eclipse, which is on the 15th of May, do not do important initiatives, traveling, like this is not very good timing. Then the next couple of eclipses, first solar is 25th of October, from 20th of October until mid-November, because the second eclipse is on the 7th of November. Be a bit careful, especially if your midheaven lower meridian happen on the axis of ninth, third houses, which is happening often. This would say, if you feel a bit too tense energies around these timings, which I gave you, this will pass. Just make sure that you, well, you do your usual spiritual practices. You pray, you welcome the sun, whatever you feel like, so that you don't feel this situation. So more or less, these are how the changes happen to you. I hope this was informative for you. So all the best in the year 2022. And if you like to have better analysis of your horoscope, you can contact me. All the best.